suspicious.
You know, I had met Mary Elizabeth, who directed it, on something else. I don't even remember what we were doing. And they were trying to find the role for Vicious, the right voice for it. And I think they were having a little trouble. And she said, man, I think you're right for this. She called me up, said, you have to come in and audition for this. And I'm like, well, okay, you know, what are they looking for? And she kind of gave me an overview of it. I said, all right. And I went in, we just did this, you know, that's real, you know. And that was it, you know, boom. And she had to get the okay, but it went pretty quickly. And next thing I know, I'm doing Vicious and loving it. Everything he does say is, it seems to be, you know, it's deliberate. You know what I mean? I mean, it's just, he doesn't mix words. He doesn't have to, which is what makes a great villain. The chatty ones aren't, you know, you're not scared of. It's the guy that doesn't say what you want him to say. Well, say something, you know, and it scares you when he doesn't. You know, when he does, it means something, you know, and gives you that shake. That's what makes a good villain. And with him, and I think this is interesting because Mary, I remember in directing, it was a constant battle to keep him way down, you know, and I can go low, but, you know, for him, they didn't want the real gravel, but it is the smoothness to his voice. And I remember it was constantly, we'd have to, Mary, can we do that again? I don't think I was quite low enough, where she'd say, you know, you need to stay down on that, stay low. All right, you know, and that's what made him smooth, and you just didn't know where he was at.
I hope it wasn't frustrating for him, but I know that it wasn't an easy process, and that has nothing to do with his acting. He said he's a brilliant actor. It's just sometimes putting yourself into a completely different place. You know, it's almost the square peg round hole situation. It just took a little bit longer than I think the other characters. But once we got there, He's amazing. I love his Vicious. It's brilliant. And again, it's different than the Japanese.
Normally, the characters that I do, or a lot of them anyway, have a lot more energy than he did. And like I said earlier, you know, you get in the booth, you do a couple of lines, you find that rhythm of the character. Because you may have been working on something else 2 hours before that, where the guy was way out here, you know. So you got to bring that down. So you do a couple of lines and you find it again. Or what will happen is they'll say, hey, do you want to hear something back? You know, yeah, let's listen to a few lines. Let's listen and get it in my head. And then we start recording.
Skip plays a character on Naruto called Gai Sensei, who is so big and over the top and almost like Elvis Presley meets Charlton Heston. And that's where he lives. You know, he lives in the grenade, he lives in the army guy, the sergeant, he lives in these big, huge characters. So for Skip to take, you know, a 180 degree turn completely and to get down in there with texture and play against Steve, who's got all this unbelievable texture and depth and everything else, and to find so that the weight of the character played against the weight of Spike, just took a while. It really did. For both of us, we had to find the character together.
I was amazed by his voice print, first of all. I mean, he has an amazing voice. And the relationship that he and Spike had, starting out as friends and ending as enemies, and ultimately, you know, fighting to the death at one point. And part of that having to do with a woman. it was an amazing relationship. And also something that I really hadn't seen much in cartoons before. I was surprised by how violent, how deep that relationship was, how guys who started out as brothers basically ended up hating each other and wanting to end each other. That was something unusual to me. And I was actually surprised by it. And I hadn't seen any of the episodes before I went into record. So to see how some of these turned out, it was pretty shocking in the booth.
So, you're finally awake. I told you before, Spike. I'm the only one who can kill you and set you free. Those words apply to you as well, Vicious. Either way, it's going to end here.